So Ukraine, as always, is an interesting position in the energy markets in Europe. It may look geographically on the margins, but it's quite a central position because of the transit of Russian gas through Ukraine to the European Union. Mm-hmm. And the transit deal in Ukraine is up for renewal at the end of the year, over which there are some questions still because it's not a done deal. Can you explain exactly what the situation is?
Well, the situation is quite urgent as 2020, it's well quite near time to approach the next year, and the transit deal haven't been signed yet. Now the trilateral negotiation is going on. It's quite tough, but constructive. So why we do need this agreement, for instance, Ukraine? Because first of all, it's almost 3% of our GDP proceeds come from transit. Secondly, we need to use our gas transportation system, and it should be under operation. This is the biggest gas transportation system in Europe. And Europe needs Russian gas because it consists 40% of consumption, and 16 countries buying gas through Ukraine from Russian Federation. So parties are interested to make this deal happen, but there is a lot of talks behind this negotiation. First of all, Ukraine want to apply European legislation, and we already implement European legislation into our national legislation. And to apply it to new deal. So basically we want new deal, not to prolong the former one.
Yes.
Secondly, we also ask for long-term contract just to make sure, and for investors, for consumers, that it would be a long-term agreement, and it will bring some certainty for European countries. And Russian Federation, they have plans to, they want to have this deal a shorter period. So this is also the discussion. Then we also negotiate volume. We negotiated very material condition, and this talk should be resume next week, the fourth round of this negotiation. So we actually expect that it would be, we have positive expectation, but everything can happen, therefore we prepare our gas system to any scenario. So we're also working on gas production. We're also thinking about how to further diversify energy flows and how to keep our country and European countries secure.
So we'll come on to the diversification in a second. But just on the deal with the Russian gas transit through Ukraine, why is it the time now not to prolong the deal, but to have a different deal?
Well, first of all, this deal come to the end. And secondly, the legislation changed completely. Since 2014, we implemented the EU directives, gas directive, into our national legislation. We are finishing the unbundling process, and now we'll have a certified gas operator who can be certified under European legislation. And of course, we want have competitive price for transit. We want companies receive more guarantees according to the European legislation. So actually our system, legal system, is fully comply with European legislation. So therefore we want to establish new deal under the European legislation.
Okay.